Welcome to St. Mark Deliverance Center, 3801 Turnpike Road in Portsmouth, Virginia, where the greatest pastor is Pastor Martha Provo. We trust that you will have a faithful year this year and a fruitful year in the year of 2021. Let's get right into worship. Hallelujah. Come on and lift your hands and let's give God praise and let's give God glory. He is an awesome, awesome Father. Hallelujah. Come on and lift your hands and let's give God. And the song says, draw me close, closer than I've ever been. Hallelujah. Into your arms, I'm drawing near again. To dwell with you is my only heart's desire. It's my only heart's desire. Oh. Cleanse me with fire and purify my heart. Draw me close, closer than before, closer than I've ever been. Oh, draw. to that secret place so I can be like you. Wrap me in your arms, Jesus. Wrap me in your arms. Oh, take me to that. To that secret place where I can be with you. You can make me like you, Jesus. Wrap me in your arms. Wrap me in your arms. Oh. Wrap me in your arms. Your arms of love. Wrap me in your arms, Jesus.
God bless you, everyone. This is Pastor P from St. Mark Deliverance Center. I pray that you're starting off your new year in a positive way with new year, new hope. We are so grateful that you're taking a part to be with us today. And so we do have a word, and the word is truly from God. And what we're excited about is what he's about to do. So if you were with us on Watch Night, we talked about stepping into a new thing in the midst of the wilderness. And we can really personalize that and make it your wilderness. And we're going to start off with one important factor. In order for us to even grab a hold of this wilderness and deal with the desert and knowing that God is with you, you're going to have to realize the importance of trusting him and believing in his word and knowing that whatever he tells you and whatever he has you to do, you have to do it and trust him to know that you're going to be successful in it no matter what. Praise the Lord. So we're going to pray and we're going to get started because we're about to do a new thing in the midst of a wilderness. And maybe you're not in a wilderness. Well, listen and take a heed because trust me, if you live on this earth and you be around long enough, you're going to fall into a wilderness. But God wants you to know, even though you might be in a dry place or in the wilderness, he said, I'll never leave you, nor will I forsake you. And his word is awesome, and it will not go void. It won't fall upon anything or the ground. It will do exactly what God has called it to do. Let's pray. Heavenly Divine Father, we thank you for today. We thank you for the opportunity to rise up. We thank you for the door opening in our mind to be in our right mind. And Father, so many didn't make it today, even when we're starting off with a new year. But you saw fit to bring us in to this new year and this new day with new mercy and much grace. Hallelujah. So Father, we believe you right now that those who have an ear, let them hear your word. And we believe you in the name of Jesus to show and bring revelation into their life even the more. We're so excited, God. And we ask you to shift the atmosphere wherever they are, be it at their home or at work and in the kitchen or in their car. Father, let them pull off to the side, God, and shift the atmosphere so they can feel your presence even the more. If they are in a wilderness place, let them feel you right now. In the desert, let them feel you right now. In a good place, still, let them feel you right now, God. And we thank you and we give you all the glory and truly all of the honor. Now, Father, let this flesh lay as you prepare us for an almighty word from you that's going to take us into another place and another level as we serve you and we do those things that you've called us to do. With great hope and with great expectations. We thank you for it in Jesus' great and almighty name. Amen and amen. Oh, my. I don't know about you, but I am expecting great and greater, because he said it in his word. So those of you who have your word out, if not, just write down the scriptures. We're going to go back into Isaiah 41 and 19. We're going to go into Isaiah 43 and 19. I'm going to be reading it from the CSB version. So just go with me as we follow the word of the Lord. Amen. The word reads, the poor and the needy seek water, but there is none. Their tongues are parched with thirst. But God said in his word, I want you to just add this, and I love this part. I will answer them. Simply put, he said, I will answer them. I am the Lord, the God of Israel. I will not abandon them. I will open rivers on the barren heights and springs in the middle of the plains. I will turn the desert into a pool of dry land into springs. Let me read that again. I will turn the desert into a pool and dry land into springs. I will plant cedar, acacia, myrtle, and olive trees in the wilderness. I will put juniper trees and elm trees and cypress trees together in the desert, so that they may see and know and consider and understand that the hand of the Lord has done this. The Holy One of Israel has created it. Amen and amen. And we're going to go into Isaiah 43 and 19. Now, I just read Isaiah 41 verses 17 through 20. I didn't know if I gave you the verses. Verses 17 through 20. We're going to go into Isaiah 43, verse 19. It's very familiar, but we're going to go into this. And I'm reading it as said, look, I am about to do a new thing. Even now it is coming. Do you not see it? Indeed, I will make a way in the wilderness, rivers in the desert. Hallelujah. Again, stepping into a new thing in the midst of the wilderness. My God. When we spoke about that, and we go into the verses of 19, and we talk about the different types of trees, the cedar trees, I do believe we've got the myrtle trees, and we got the myrtle trees, we got the olive trees, and the different types of trees we've got set out here. We even got the juniper trees, the cypress trees. And we want you to look up on these trees and try to figure out exactly what it is. Why is it so important with these trees? The types of trees are very important because they symbolize something that's going to be a part of your wilderness, that's going to assist you and help you in the middle of your dry place. The cedar tree, let's go to that one. It works as a windbreak or a windbreaker. If you've been into a storm and you try to find a place or a shade, God is setting up a place or a shade for that cedar tree to, it symbolizes strength, that it will block, hallelujah, the storm from you. It's not that you're not going to feel some of it. It's not that you're not going to even go through some of it, but he is going to block that storm. He's going to allow some things to penetrate because it's a part of growth, but he's not going to let everything take you out. That's the type of God that we serve. Isn't it something? The cedar tree. And I said, God, how awesome is that? The acacia tree. It's a substance. It's a grateful tree. It's graced. And it's a type of tree, which is the gum part of that tree, actually is used for relieving pain. And it's good for a source of fiber. And the important part of that is also have flowers that you can eat. So when you're at a place of nourishment, God is setting you up to a place where you can have flowers that are they're edible. You can have that, you can eat those types. And it also, we talk about the myrtle. The myrtle tree is an evergreen, kind of a scrub type tree. And what it does, it literally produces flowers, one that has a fragrance, and it also have blackberries. And I looked at that as I'm studying it, and I'm going through my notes here as well. And it was a blessing to see God in the middle of your dry place would put a tree that have flowers of fragrance. That fragrance would bring forth peace. That fragrance would give you into a place of just knowing that God has this. So he's trying to get you in a place to understand that I'm going to put a pool of water in your desert. I'm going to set you up with a cedar tree with strength that's going to block some of the storm that you're going through, that will cause the storm to mind itself with you, or as we would say, peace be still. And then it will give you nourishment. That is the type of God we serve. Whether you put yourself in that wilderness or we know we're going through one because of life, God said, I'm setting you up. So each tree has a symbol. It symbolizes something. It gives you something. And the cedar tree is going to give you that strength that you need. Now, the olive tree is something else because it symbolizes something that's called indestructible. You say, wait a minute, indestructible? When you have God on your side, nothing is too hard for God. And when I'm going to read to you about the olive tree, the root system of the olive tree is so robust that it's capable of regenerating itself even above the ground. We know what the roots would do, but this one right here, my God, he set you up so that even in the midst of what you're going through, he's letting you see and letting you know, my God, that you are instructable as long as you stand with me, as long as you're there, as long as you're reading my word, as long as you're praying, as long as you're crying out to me. I'm going to set you up in such a way, and it's one that can regenerate. So whatever the storm might have taken out from you, it will generate itself, regenerate itself, and cause that thing to come to life. My God, it says that the ground structure of the tree can be destroyed by the frost, fire, or whatever. It will regenerate itself, and it's longevity. Longevity. So God is letting you know that I am going to set you up, and you're going to be in a place that no matter what you're going through, it will regenerate itself back to life. Whatever you might have lost, whatever you thought the devil took from you, it will regenerate itself back. Hallelujah. My God, it's causing me to want to jump up and talk about the Lord even the more. And so when we look at that in the juniper tree, it has berries. And when we look at that, it says it helps to protect your cells against the damage that otherwise would call illness. There are things that are in trees that are natural that we need to use, natural things that will help our bodies. And with this type of berries, it helps protect your cells against the damages that would otherwise will cause or lead up to illnesses. That is an awesome thing to see that God is setting you up with the water that you need, the nourishment that you are in need of, protecting you from the storm of life, and making sure that whatever you take is going to be used to make sure there is no damage in your own body cell system so that you can be strong and live long. That is the type of trees that he gave us, symbolizing peace, his glory, his strength, longevity, indestructible. That's what he's saying that you are. Even in the midst of your wilderness, you are indestructible as long as you stand with him. Yes, we know that we're human and things can happen and we understand what can be. But God said, as long as you stand with me, that's where your faith has got to come in. No, we're not Superman and no, we're not Spider-Man, but we are child of God. One who can see, one who can look around and protect us and block us, God. How many of you been blocked from a car accident? How many of you been blocked from diseases? How many of you been blocked, God, from people coming at you? That's the type of God and the type of indestructible way he's trying to tell you, stand with me. Hallelujah. I come against any type of early death. I call them premature. If God did not tell me I am dying on tomorrow and I won't know, but he gave me a promise and he let me know there's still more for me to do for 2021, then I am going to stand and believe that 2021 belongs to me. And as long as I stand on his word, I'm going to do it. And when he said, not man, then I will go up and see the Lord and be happy about it, because I was on earth doing the work that he has called me to do. Hallelujah, hallelujah. We're going to go a little bit further. I'm telling you, I'm so grateful and so blessed about this. Now, one thing that can help us realize the importance of our desert wandering, because we have our own desert wandering. We can go out and we can just be doing things on our own, but God still said, I am going to be there for you, even if you put yourself in it. Parents, different one of us, we are parents. We see things going on with our children. We look, but we have to turn them over to God. And we have to believe that God has them. And we have to know that no weapon formed against them shall prosper. So that's where your faith comes in. So if they're in a desert, if they're in a dry place, trust the Lord that he's going to put trees just like he did for you. He is going to do it for them. So it's so important as parents to stand on the word of God. It's so important as pastors to stand on the word of God, because you all don't realize some of it, and I'm just getting started in the pastoring, that some of this thing can take you out, especially with things that are going on in the world as of today. Oh, my Father, I give him praise that he set me up in my right mind, believing him by faith and knowing that his word is true and I can stand on it. And we can walk around speaking it and look upon it and say, it is so. It is so. Because the two important things that go on in a desert and or wilderness is the sun that beats down on you and the dryness of the land. But you have to remember in Psalms, in Isaiah 41, it states that he said, I'm going to give you a pool of water right in the middle of your dry place. And he also reminded you and let us all know that I am going to ensure, my God, that I'm going to plant trees that will give you shade, that will give you strength, that will cause peace, that will bring a fragrance in the air and in the atmosphere, that will cause you to know that God is with you. And he said, I will not abandon you. What a mighty God we serve. So some of the things that we're talking about, I want you to really note. I'm going to go into my other part here and note that the importance of being in your storm is that don't allow sin to get into that place with you. Sin will always take you further than you want to go. And what I mean by sin, we're talking about the things of gossiping or attitude, or you know the sins that you're going through. Sometimes when we're in the wilderness, it will cause us to go back. Some of us might have been through drinking and drugs, but God is reminding you, don't allow sin, because it will push you in the dry place further than you want to go. And God said, no, I will not leave you, but you're going to be sitting in there longer than you need to. As we remember the Israelites who were in there for 40 years, it is something to know that if they did not have to be there, but because of their ways and how they decided to turn themselves from God into idols. So God wants to remind us, do not allow sin while you in there. If you need someone, call on that person that can pray with you, that can stand with you. Call on the Lord who said, I'll never leave you, nor will I abandon you. Hallelujah. So we have talked about the water. We have spoke of the different type of trees. And that is something to know. He's giving you nourishment and what they all symbolize. Strength. Indestructible. It's awesome to see the move of God right in the middle of your wilderness. That is the only way that you can walk into a new thing. Now, we're about to go into that right now. The only way that you can go into your new thing is to realize the things that God has planted in your wilderness. Oh my, I feel the Holy Spirit. He planted all of this, a fragrance of peace, strength, stability, longevity, so that you can make it through the storm of life and come out a whole new person or doing a new thing. So while you in your desert place, while you in a place that you're not sure exactly how to come out of it, just follow God, follow the leading of the Holy Spirit, and he'll take you right through it. Allow him to nourish you. Allow him to feed you. Allow him to bring water to you when you're thirsty. Don't walk in with an attitude. Say, God, I need thee. I need thee every hour. Oh, Lord, I need thee. And he will come. He said, why is it so hard for us to believe what he says? Because if he's inside of us, you carry him. So he cannot leave you, nor will he abandon you, because you carry him. But the important thing is that you have to get that word in you. Feed the word to your soul. Ebando sandarabase. Feed it to your soul so that whenever the enemy comes in and try to attack you, even in your dry place, because that's one of the best places that he can take you, is right there in that dry place and try to attack you there. You let them know, God, that they know that you cannot live by bread alone, but you're living by the word of the Lord God, and that you begin to feed that thing, the scriptures, and it has to flee. It cannot sit under the anointing. It cannot set under what God has promised you. It can't stay there. Hallelujah. You've got to come from your negativity to believe in God that he's going to lift you up out of your place and set your feet on solid ground. And he's going to give you a purpose and a hope. Hallelujah. Oh, I feel him today. I want you to get excited for 2021. You don't have to sit still in that corner. You don't have to take all of that stuff that you feel the people are giving you. You can stand up and say, I have a God who told me that I am great and mighty before him, that I am a queen before him, that I am loved, that I am needed, and there is a purpose for my life. You got to get to a place of purpose. My Lord, let me bring it in. I'm getting excited. Hallelujah. So I'm about to close, but I want you to know that the trees that he plants symbolizes everything that you need in a dry place. Everywhere you go, take them with you. That's strength. Take the peace of God. Take the fragrance of the flower. Take the berries of nourishment. Use each and everything that God gives you. Put on that battle, that garment of praise. Be prepared, as we speak in Ephesians, to have on your war clothes in the name of Jesus, and prepare yourself for war. And let the devil know you will not retreat, nor will you back down on what he's promised you and what belongs to you. Oh, my. Let me close here. But I want you to get excited. Stop the complaining. Stop the grumbling. Stop the hearsay this and he and she saying that. Begin to put on that helmet. Put on that whole armor, my God, and get yourself ready and tell the devil and let him know you don't know who you just mess with, and bring forth the word of God, because you're in a new year with new hope, doing new things. God said, right in the middle of your wilderness, I am going to do a new thing. I'm going to read this out to you in my closing. Every tree, every gift, every talent, every ability, everything that God plants was designed to give him glory. There is space for you to flourish. There is room for you to thrive. There is no competition in Christ. Choose to obey and align your steps with his word, and he will cause you to succeed. And you have to realize something, that sometimes when we find ourselves there in a place where we are in that wilderness, we just need that reminder from the whisper of God deep down in our soul that my presence will go with you and I will give you rest. Whatever you're facing, be assured that God is with you. He's providing your needs and he's making a way out of no way. He is our miracle working Father. And he said in his word, there's simply nothing too hard for him. Hallelujah. And so we are so blessed that you were with us on today. And we want you to know that God is doing something mighty and great for 2021. And he wants each and every one of us to be a part of it. So no matter what you're going through, God has already planted in your wilderness trees for shade, for nourishment, for peace, for food to eat, berries, fragrances. Oh my goodness, he has set us up. We just need to take the time, sit back, read his word, and wait for him to give us orders and or guidance, and know that he is a mighty God, and you're not in it alone. God bless you. I believe the Lord for those who are saying to themselves, I'm a backslider. I believe God when he says he's married to the backslider. So come back. Come right in. You're welcome in this place, not just in a building, but he wants to come into your heart. And those who don't know the Lord or Jesus for yourself, he said, I welcome you to me. All you have to do is believe that he was born and he was here and he died. Jesus died for our sins. And on the third day, he rose again and he left us with the Holy Spirit to do greater works than even him. All you need to do is say yes to him. And he in turn will guide you through his word, through prayer. And as he brings revelation to you through vision and or dreams. God is just that kind of God. He's a good, good father. And he wants you to know that I'll never abandon you, even in your wilderness. Call us at 757-399-9915. Leave a message if we're not there. And because of this COVID-19, our hours are changing, but you can better believe we are going to contact you again. And we want to send you something that will help encourage you. God bless you. We love you. And until we meet again, which will be soon, may the Lord God Almighty rest upon you, keep you, have you in a place of peace, knowing that he is secured around you with love and abilities to stand whatever storm that you might be in. Just call on the name of Jesus. And he said, I'll be there. God bless you. Have an awesome day. In the Lord.